Penguin Random House Audio presents AstroLit, A Bibliophile's Guide to the Stars by McCormick Templeman and Rachel Fader. Read for you by Karen Murray. With a preface and note on cusp figures read by McCormick Templeman. For Isak Schursen, Still the Grumpiest Saint, M.T. For Jed Fader and Tiffany Tatro, Two of My Favorite Stars, R.F.
Preface. Why AstroLit? This book started with a really, really good plate of tofu. Once upon a time, two astrology buffs and literary studies scholars, that's us, were grabbing a quick lunch and chatting about their shared teaching and research projects. Before they, or we knew it, we had Percy Bysshe Shelley, Mary Shelley, and Lord Byron's charts open. We were looking at what the birth of Frankenstein's monster had to do with the stars. And let us tell you, those birth charts were helpful. Here's the thing about literary studies. While novels, poetry, plays, and other literary creations are based in history, biography, and reality, they often aren't true per se. Even so, they can reveal deep truths about the human experience, sometimes better than straightforward truth-telling can. In literary studies, we try to squeeze the juice out of literary artifacts. Our juice press of choice is usually a question, topic, or theory that we bring to bear on the literature in question. So we ask, how do we read Pride and Prejudice differently if we look at it through the lens of gender? How about through the lens of economics, or real estate, or storytelling style, or law? Through the lens of Jane Austen's own broken engagement? She was a total Sagittarius. With this in mind, AstroLit was born from a simple question. Namely, what would happen if we looked at literary history through the lens of astrology? We contend that astrology, like literature, is beautiful and useful, whether or not you believe it's true. Like literature, astrology can spur us to action, inspire us to nurture our gifts, and encourage a deeper understanding of ourselves and others. And like literature, astrology is creative and inspiring and downright fun. So what happens when we look at literary history through the lens of astrology? You hold the answer in your hands. A book of revelations about literary figures, a guide to famous and lesser-known masterpieces, and a collection of prompts for readers, listeners, writers, and book lovers of all kinds. We hope this little book will be an important resource for you and yours for years to come. The sky's the limit. Yours with hearts and stars, McCormick and Rachel.
A review of astrological terms. Signs and symbols. The zodiac is divided into 12 signs, and each sign is signified by a symbol and a glyph. Aries, the ram. Taurus, the bull. Gemini, the twins. Cancer, the crab. Leo, the lion. Virgo, the maiden. Libra, the scales. Scorpio, the scorpion. Sagittarius, the archer. Capricorn, the goat. Aquarius, the water bearer. Pisces, the fish. Planets. Each of the signs is ruled by a planet, or in some cases, two. They are as follows. Aries is ruled by Mars. Taurus is ruled by Venus. Gemini is ruled by Mercury. Cancer is ruled by the moon. Leo is ruled by the sun. Virgo is ruled by Mercury. Libra is ruled by Venus. Scorpio is ruled by Mars and Pluto. In astrology, Pluto is recognized as a planet, although they seem to be calling it a dwarf planet these days. Sagittarius is ruled by Jupiter. Capricorn is ruled by Saturn. Aquarius is ruled by Saturn and Uranus. Pisces is ruled by Jupiter and Neptune. Elements. Each sign is ruled by one of the four elements, giving each of the signs an associated elemental flavor. They are grouped as follows. Fire, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Earth, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Air, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Water, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Qualities. Each of the signs is endowed with a quality or mode that speaks to the kind of energy it holds. A sign is either cardinal, fixed, or mutable. Cardinal signs are initiating and are the signs that begin each season of the year. Fixed signs are stable and unchanging and occupy the middle of a season. Mutable signs are dynamic and represent the transition from one season into the next. Cardinal signs: Aries, Cancer, Libra, Capricorn. Fixed signs: Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. Mutable signs: Gemini, Virgo, Sagittarius, Pisces. Houses. The zodiac is divided into 12 houses. Each house deals with a different aspect of life, and although each individual's birth chart will differ in terms of which sign rules which house, there is a natural ruler of each house. They are as follows. First house, self, Aries. Second house, material wealth and prosperity, Taurus. Third house, communication, siblings, immediate environment, Gemini. Fourth house, home and family, Cancer. Fifth house, romance, creativity, and children, Leo. Sixth house, health and daily work, Virgo. Seventh house, partnership, Libra. Eighth house, sex, death, and other people's money, Scorpio. Ninth house, philosophy, higher education, and travel, Sagittarius. 10th house, career, Capricorn. 11th house, friends and social networks, Aquarius. 12th house, the unknown, Pisces. Detriment. When a planet is positioned in the sign opposite its natural ruler, the planet is in its detriment, a sign it does not like to occupy. Think of it as a space where one is naturally uncomfortable. We say a planet is in its detriment when it falls in these signs. The sun is in its detriment in Aquarius. The moon is in its detriment in Capricorn. Mercury is in its detriment in Sagittarius and Pisces. Venus is in its detriment in Aries and Scorpio. Mars is in its detriment in Taurus and Libra. Jupiter is in its detriment in Gemini and Virgo. Saturn is in its detriment in Cancer and Leo. Exaltation. Sometimes a planet is exalted, meaning especially well situated in a particular sign. The exaltations are as follows. The sun is exalted in Aries. The moon is exalted in Taurus. Mercury is exalted in Virgo. Venus is exalted in Pisces. Mars is exalted in Capricorn. Jupiter is exalted in Cancer. Saturn is exalted in Libra. A review of literary terms. Allusion. An indirect reference to something else. Anaphora, repeating the first word of a line. Avant-garde, innovative for its historical period. Ballad, a popular narrative poem or song. Bildungsroman, a novel focused on the formative years of its main character. Canonical, widely respected and regarded as high art. Decadent, focused on the aesthetics of excess and artificiality. Denouement, the resolution of a plot. Double entendre, double meaning. Dramatic monologue, passage spoken by one character, either as part of a play or as a standalone poem. Epistles, letters. Epistolary, taking the form of letters. Genre, a category of art with an established set of conventions and expectations. Examples include mystery, science fiction, and literary fiction. Gothic, dark, suspenseful literature, often including supernatural or seemingly supernatural specters and cavernous spaces haunted by a strange relationship to the past. Hybrid literature, work that combines or draws from multiple genres. Juvenilia, work often unpublished, produced when a writer or other artist was still young and before they developed their mature style. Postmodern, work that comes after modernism, sometimes notable for its self-aware experimental style. Realist, realism, literature that adheres to the depth and complexity of reality and pays attention to the systems and structures that define the lives of different people in the real world. Rhetoric, a kind of discourse intended to persuade. Romantic romanticism, literature that originated in the late 18th and early 19th centuries, often marked by heightened emotions and a deep engagement with nature. Roman à clé, a novel representing actual people or events in disguised form. Satire, a work of art that relies heavily on ironic, humorous representation, usually as a means of social criticism. Sentimental, a term used to describe 18th century and later fiction focused on eliciting an emotional response from the reader. Sonnet, a 14-line poem, often with some sort of turn or volta. Speaker, conventional term used to write or talk about who is speaking in a poem without mixing that voice up with the poet. The idea of the speaker makes the most sense when discussing a poem where a character is speaking, such as a dramatic monologue. Transcendentalist, transcendentalism. An American philosophical movement from the mid-19th century that focused on the goodness of people and nature and the connections between everyday life and divine experience. Victorian, referring to the period when Queen Victoria ruled in England, corresponding roughly with the second half of the 19th century, 1837 to 1901. Aries, the incisive writer. The child is father of the man. William Wordsworth. Aries 101. Sign overview. Symbol, the ram. Element, fire. Quality, cardinal. House ruled, first, self. Planetary ruler, Mars. Positive traits, courageous, passionate, trailblazers. Negative traits, pushy, impatient, bellicose. Aries are something of a zodiacal Rorschach test. They are what they are, and they are that thing to the extreme, but what you make of them tends to say more about you than it does about them. A cardinal fire sign and the natural ruler of the first house, Aries starts the zodiac out with a bang. The first house is the house of the self. It is the realm of personal power, calculated trajectory, and self-focus. It's no surprise, then, that Aries can sometimes err on the side of egotism. As the first of the 12 signs, Aries are the originators of the zodiac. They create the path that the rest of us walk, but they can sometimes be a little aggressive about telling us how to walk it. They are also associated with youth and with a potentially harmful refusal to grow up. That same youthful enthusiasm that helps them move mountains and inspires the rest of us to follow them with awed devotion can twist into bratty self-centeredness if they're not careful. Symbolized by the ram, Aries surge out into the world with temerity and courage. They confront every issue head on, horns forward.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.